Chapter 248, Fiancé. Qin Lai was still dazed, still trapped in an illusory state. Even long after Song Tin had departed, he was still standing there expressionlessly, puzzled which world he was truly in. Tong Jiwa, Tang Siki, and Lian Ra looked at him from afar with puzzled expressions on their faces. Why had Song Tin suddenly flown away? When Song Tin had left, the three clearly saw that Song Tin had slightly been panicked. It seemed something unexpected had occurred, considering the manner in which she had left. What had really happened? The battle of concepts was usually mysterious. Only the participants would know what had occurred. Outsiders had no way of discerning what had happened with only just their eyes. Qin Lai. Tong Jiwa shouted, hoping for Qin Lai to wake up. His shout was like a bolt of lightning that pierced Qin Lai's mind. The dazed Qin Lai shook in response as his eyes finally became clear again. He could feel a thread of light shooting out of a soul-suppressing orb which instantly eliminated any remaining confusion. The mist that shrouded his mind was blown away. The scenes that seemed so clear and realistic shattered under the illumination of this light. He seemed to hear some unusual object in his mind be cleansed by the light. Little did he know that it was exactly the imprint left by the seed that Song Tin had implanted in his mind. So he completely recovered and was wholly awake. He knew who he was, where he was, and knew what was true and what was false. Such a scary woman. Thinking back to the scenes he had seen, he broke out in a cold sweat. He knew that Song Tin's strange concept had enchanted his soul and almost broke through his mind. If that had occurred, he would then always possess Song Tin's figure deep within in his heart, shackled by its influence for the rest of his lifetime. Without the soul-suppressing orb which cleansed his mind would forever possess a hole in its defenses, one which Song Tin could always enter through, entering and exiting his mind to control his emotions as she pleased. Are you alright? Tang Siki walked to his side and looked at him with worry. What did that woman do to you? You don't look too good. Qin Lai, what did that Song Tin do? Lian asked. Furrowing his brow, Qin Lai thought and then said, she tried to enchant my mind, attempting to envelop it in her charm. However, it seems she didn't succeed and gave up. That's why she left. What he did not know was that Song Tin had left because the soul-suppressing orb had instead reflected her influence. It inflicted a deep imprint of him onto her mind instead, so she had hurriedly retreated. That woman will not rest. She is an envoy from Profound Heaven Alliance and the only daughter of Song Yu. This time, she has left for an unknown reason, but she will come back to find us, Tong Jiwa said heavily. We will deal with her when she returns. For now, let's just wait. Qin Lai looked at Tang Siki. Senior Sister Tang, are the Terminator Profound Bombs ready to be turned into spirit artifacts?
Yes.
Tang Siki smiled and took out 6 fist-sized metal balls and then subsequently handed them to Qin Lai. Check and see if there are any problems. Taking the 6 Terminator Profound Bombs, Qin Lai used his mind consciousness to feel them. He smiled slightly and nodded. They are all very good. I can inscribe spirit diagrams directly inside. When the spirit diagrams are finished, then these Terminator Profound Bombs will be truly complete. Haha, it is good that I can be of help to you, Tang Siki smiled happily. She was smiling, but there was a thread of worry in her eyes for Qin Lai. That Song Tinu's beauty was something that even she, a woman, sighed over. Song Tinu was also skilled spirit arts of seduction, could cast a wondrous concept. She was worried that Qin Lai would not be able to withstand Song Tinu's charm. Furthermore, she was afraid that Qin Lai would fall sooner or later, becoming Song Tinu's subject and that he would faithfully serve her. This was something she did not want to see. But she realized that she was powerless to stop it. It took a great deal of time to forge the 6 Terminator Profound Bombs, but it did not take very long to inscribe spirit diagrams. The wooden house Song Tinu had stayed in was the one that Armament Sect had built specifically for Qin Lai. It was a building that belonged to him, the house of the sect master. With the 6 Terminator Profound Bombs in hand, Qin Lai entered inside. He had the blood guards stand guard outside so that he could inscribe the spirit diagrams in peace. After half a day, he finished inscribing spirit diagrams on the Terminator Profound Bombs. After a moment of thought, he called in Tang Siki. You were looking for me? Tang Siki was wearing a long silk dress woven with flower patterns. She walked in with a smile and asked, you have already inscribed all the spirit diagrams?
Amen.
Qin Lai handed one over. Take a look and see if you can perceive the spirit diagrams inside with your mind consciousness. I added a secret sealing method on the outside in hopes that I can conceal the compound diagrams within. That's what you should do. What you use are ancient diagrams. If other people see this, it will only create trouble. Also, the Terminator Profound Bomb itself is a very serious matter. Anything about it should be kept as secret as possible. Taking a Terminator Profound Bomb from Qin Lai's hands, Tang Siki gathered her mind consciousness to inspect its insides. She found there were layers of mist that covered the core like a curtain, resulting in her being completely unable to see anything. She nodded and said, you have done very well. I am unable to see the spirit diagrams inside. There shouldn't be a problem now. There is one other matter. After a moment of thought, Qin Lai said, you and I worked on forging the Terminator Profound Bomb together. You should have a general understanding of the forging process. If there are still steps you do not understand, tell me and I will explain them for you. In the future, you will forge the Terminator Profound Bombs and I will just inscribe the spirit diagrams. When these words were spoken, Tang Siki's beautiful eyes lit up. Senior Zhu Li once said that you shouldn't reveal anything about the Terminator Profound Bomb. It is best if you do everything yourself. Aren't you afraid that I will leak Terminator Profound Bomb's forging process? I trust you, Qin Lai said seriously. Tang Siki's smile was bright as she said, completely pleased. All right, as long as you believe in me, I will do my best to forge Terminator Profound Bombs for you. Many thanks, Senior Sister Tang. It should be me thanking you for your trust in me. Over the next few days, Tang Siki was responsible for forging the Terminator Profound Bombs. After she finished forging them, Kinlai would then inscribe the spirit diagrams. In the area of forging, Tang Siki had great talent. After just a bit of guidance from Kinlai, Tang Siki didn't have any problems when forging the Terminator Profound Bombs. As a result, the forging of the Terminator Profound Bombs passed without incident. Kinlai focused on his frost arts and adding spirit diagrams to the bombs. In a short 6 days, 35 of them had been produced. Everyone a part of armament sect was excited. At the bottom of the Arctic mountain range, Kinlai sat on top of a glacier, his eyes closed, then turned to a statue of ice as he worked on cultivating the frost. There was still one natal palace remaining. Only after creating his 9th natal place would he truly be considered to have reached the peak of the natal opening realm and achieved the qualifications to rise to the manifestation realm. After having recently participated in battles and comprehending more on inscribing spirit diagrams, he felt that it would not be difficult for him to break into the manifestation realm. He needed to form the 9th natal palace. Due to this, after 35 Terminator Profound Bombs were made, he had Tang Siki continue to use armament sex spirit materials to continue forging the base for more Terminator Profound Bombs. He took the opportunity to come to the bottom of Arctic mountain range, intending to use the cruel cold and the thick ice present to form his 9th natal palace. He was in the state of thoughtless tranquility and almost completely lost himself. He only gathered the cold energy and funneled all the cold energy around him into his spirit sea. Unknowingly, after he had stepped into the Arctic mountain range, a peerlessly handsome man from Mage Extreme Temple had come to the poisonous bog. He was called Mohi. Mohi quickly found where armament sect was, but he did not disturb the people there. Instead, he used a secret technique to listen to the conversations between the people of armament sect. He quickly learned that Kinlai was not here but was cultivating in the deeper part of the poisonous bog, so he proceeded deeper into the bog. With his terrifying mind consciousness, he covered large portions of the bog, too carefully searching for Kinlai. But it was a pity that Kinlai was at the bottom of Arctic mountain range. He searched the poisonous bog for a long period of time and almost went through the majority of it, but he still could not find Kinlai. He found Song Tinu instead. In a remote corner of the poisonous bog, Song Tinu was sitting cross-legged on a flowing cloud rainbow butterfly. She was under the thick canopy of a few ancient trees and was still trying to get rid of the imprint that Kinlai had left behind on her mind. Before this, she had never had a backlash, so it was the first time she encountered such a state. She had no experience in cleaning out Kinlai's influence whatsoever, so she was simply slowly exploring. When Mohi's powerful soul-searching technique covered this area, she was instantly disturbed. The flowing cloud rainbow butterfly she was on lightly flapped its wings in the air. "Who is it?" Song Tinu called quietly. "The Miss of the Song family, Song Tinu." Mohi's beautiful figure appeared, his feet not even touching the ground. He stopped under where Song Tinu was. "Why are you in the poisonous bog, Senior Mohi?" When Song Tinu saw the incomer, she was shocked inside. Then, she smiled brightly. "If Senior Mohi can come to the poisonous bog, why can't I? Senior, you have covered the area with a soul-searching technique. Who are you searching for?"
"I'm looking for Kinlai."
Mohi was open and directly stated his intentions. "The Holy Master has sent out an order. He wants something from Kinlai, so he has sent me." "What is Senior supposed to take from Kinlai?" Song Tinu asked, her expression unchanging. "His memory, spatial spirit artifact, and Terminator Profound Bomb." Mohi smiled slightly. "Then you want to take my fiancé's life?" suddenly said Song Tinu's right after her eyes swirled. Mohi's expression changed. "Fiancé? When did he become your fiancé?"
"Not long ago."
Song Tinu smiled and a threat of embarrassment appeared on her face. "Senior, will you kill my fiancé?"
"Right now, the evil races of the Netherrealm are about to invade, yet you want to kill my fiancé? Are Profound Heaven Alliance and 8 Extreme Temple still going to be allies?"